Hi there. I want to start by thanking everyone. Over 15,000 people, they watch my video, which I uploaded a year ago, about transplanting cycads and also propagating the cycad seeds. And now is the time here from South Africa to come back with the update, which is long promised. And I will take you to those Encephalatos princeps, which we transplanted a year ago, to see how they're doing.
As you remember, and you've seen on the video, this was the mother plant. It had four suckers, which we took off. As you see, after a year, it healed fantastically. You don't see, besides Nero, you don't see any scars or any damage to it. On top of that, it produces more suckers. I can see here, 1, 2, and 3. They're still very small. I will suggest to leave them for another, probably about 2 years, until they develop their own roots. And then the process starts again. This was one of the plants which we took from it. It was the sort of second biggest one. You'll see it produced another sucker, which is quite amazing. I don't want to turn the plant because the plant is not good to be turned. It's always good to keep in the same position. And if you want to move them, you always make a sign and let's go to the north, and you keep that position all the time, orientated to the north. It's got another sucker, which is probably in 1 year or 2 years time also I can take out. We go to the other ones. That's a beauty, very firm, solid. It produces leaves, new leaves every year. That means last year we transplanted and it produced a set of new leaves. This came very nice out. That was the third one. And if you remember this plant, it had no bulb whatsoever. There were just some shoots coming out on an angle. And now it produced a bulb. It's still on the side, which is fine because the leaves, they will orientate it vertically. And sometimes it's actually nicer for a cycad to have a different shape, because it makes it more interesting. And the last one here, very firm roots, and I'm totally happy of the success. If you do it properly, there's no reason whatsoever for the plant not to prosper, because they want to stay alive, like they stood for thousands of years, and they survivors definitely. I take this opportunity to show you also this magnificent plant, which I purchased this plant about 7 years ago. It was just a bulb of about 300 diameter. And as you see today, after 7 years, the size of it, actually the pot is getting very small. It's covered the whole pot. This one needs definitely a transplant. But I intended it to do it this year. I don't want to disturb it, because it's a female. It produced a cone, and this is all what we wait the cycad growers, is to produce seeds and to propagate them. As you see the size of the cone,
It's humongous. At the end, I will have probably in a region of 300 seeds. I don't know at this stage if they are fertilized or not. Fertile. I have to wait to take the cover off, and then I will be left with the seed. And if you remember the video, I will see which one is the floater, which one is the sinker, and I will try them all and to propagate them and then to see what it will happen. But the beauty of it, it's spectacular. To bring an update also to the previous video of propagating and planting the seeds, I will bring you here. Here are those Trispinosus blue, what we propagated and from the seeds. They're doing fantastic. As you see this one, it produces a new set of leaves. The seed is still here, and they're doing great. They're doing great. On this you see more clearly. This is the old leaves. It had 1, 2, 3 leaves, old ones, and this one, it came a new one now, which already changed the color, and that means they're doing very well. All what we have to do when you decide to get involved with cycads, you need passion, you need patience, and you need love for this plant, because it takes a long time until they show you the beauty of them. And never lose faith, because eventually the leaf, it will come out, and the cone, it will come out, and in one day you will have the huge satisfaction of taking a seed and planting it and produce a plant like that. And we don't have to forget, this plant was also a seed. I want to take you to show you the, now is spring in South Africa, I want to take you to show you the explosion of cycad, especially of the natalensis in South Africa in spring. Come with me. In this portion of the garden, I planted about 7-10 years ago, I would say, all natalensis, and they're doing fantastically. You can see the very healthy plants, and every year they give me a tremendous amount of new leaves. As you see, every single one, it starts the new leaves. Now is the season. What we have to be very careful is to protect them from the insects, from the tiger butterfly. He comes and he lays the eggs on the leaves, and then they kill the leaves. That means what I do now, I will give them insecticide spray, and that it will protect the leaves. As you see, the leaves, they're intact. I like them to be intact. I don't want them with holes. I don't want them. I want them to protect them, because that's why I'm here, and the grower is there to protect the plant. We have to intervene. It's a tough plant. It's a very strong plant. But we have to intervene from time to time if we want the plant to be healthy and to prosper and to grow. Every single one has got new leaves. This is my favorite. It's got 3 heads. And to see when the leaves, they will grow, it will effectively, you won't know which one is coming from where. With this, I will say thank you again, and
A special thank for the subscribers, which they subscribed to my video, hoping in one day I will come back with the update, which today it happened. And see you next time, when I will have some more news and something to share with you. I will upload another video. If you've got any questions, please ask me. I will answer them on my best of my capacity. And farewell, and look after the plants and enjoy them. Bye-bye.